We're here with Joe Beard. And Joe, so what initially got you into music?
You know, I grew up with the Murphy brothers, Matt Guitar Murphy, Floyd Murphy.
Nice.
And also there was an old gentleman by the name of Nathan Beauregard. When I was like 6, 7 years old, he was a blind guy. In Mississippi, I used to lead him around to the houses to play his house parties. And there was a gentleman by the name of Ernie Scruggs, just a great guitar player, but he was never known.
Huh.
But he was the best. Even Matt Guitar Murphy learned things from him.
Wow.
And I heard B.B. King say at one time, because B.B. King was also, I grew up during that same era with B.B. King. I knew him in those days also. And he said that Ernest Scruggs was the best he had ever seen.
Wow.
And he was never known to anybody except the people around him.
And so you've been playing now for how long? You started at what age?
No, but you know, all those years I was with all those great guitar players, did you know I didn't play guitar until I was 18 years old?
Wow.
You know, I would sing for those guitar players, but I would never touch the guitar. I started playing guitar when I was 18 years old.
So what made you make the decision to go ahead and start playing yourself?
But you know, I always felt though that it was something I wanted to do. I knew that from the very beginning. When I was a bass player for the Soul Brothers Six, remember the song, Some Kind of Wonderful?
Yes.
Well, the guy that written that song, him and I and Lincoln Day started a band in Rochester, New York. That was the first time that I'd really start to perform with.
And then you played for a while, and we had been talking a bit at the hotel a few days back, and then you kind of took a break and started and raised a family.
Yes, there was four kids. I had four kids. And I chose to raise the kids instead of become a musician at that time. And to this day, I feel though I did the right thing.
I agree from what we talked about a few days
yes.
ago. They've turned
yes.
out wonderful. You got some
yes.
really, really great kids there.
Yes, I do. I sure do.
So what spurred you to get back in?
Well, I knew this is something I always wanted to do. You know, then in the 60s, I ran into Buddy Guy, Junior Wells, Luther Allison.
Nice.
You know,
just a few of your casual guys.
Yes. You know, to this day, you know what I mean? Buddy and I, we still do things together. In June of this year, we did the Jazz Fest in Rochester, New York, where I live.
And so here you are, 17th annual blues concert, Chad Kassem.
Yes.
How do you love this venue, this church?
I love it. It's awesome.
I mean, it sounds great, and it's almost like, especially with the blues, when you play it, it's like you're preaching.
Yeah. You know, I guess you could say that, yes.
You know.
The first song that I did tonight, you know, that I did today a few minutes ago, you
yeah.
know, that's, I written that song some time ago. I also recorded it too, you know. And other song that I did, When I Get Drunk.
Yeah.
I recorded that song in 1989. And amazingly, that the same bass player that's here today is the guy that's on the recording. Louis,
wow.
You know.
So it's about as authentic as it gets here.
Yes, it is. It certainly is.
Oh.
And Marquise, you know, he's...
Yeah.
He's a great guy, and he's a great musician, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And his head is in the right place for the blues, you know.
That brings up a good point. A lot of people say you have to live the blues to really play it. What do you think?
Well, living the blues is something I don't understand. You know, the blues is life itself, you know?
True, well, as is music.
You know, every song that I've written, it's about something that I have done, something I have experienced, or something I saw someone else do.
Do.
You know? And all of it's not nice. You know, it's not the greatest thing in the world, but that is the truth. The blues is the truth, you know.
And speaking of the truth, how would you define music? If you had to put a definition to it.
You know, music is something that everybody understands. Everybody understands music, you know. I don't care what country you go to or who you meet. And if you got an instrument, if you play music, that's when it's a universal language. Everybody understands music. You may not know what you say or why you're saying it or the reason for it, but they understand that it's music.
Talking through music. Well, thank you very much for taking the time to be with us. We really do appreciate it.
Yes.
And of course, you love the blues, right? So let's give them and yourselves a big hand right now. So, okay, I thank them. Thank you, Chad. Of course, you know, he puts the show on, and that's all I'll say. You're not going to applaud for Chad, the guy? Okay, ready? Okay. Now, once again, I ask the question, do you want me to talk more or do you want any music? You know, you don't have to be so adamant about getting me off the stage. I do have feelings. Okay. For you that don't want to hear me, when he was 16 years old, he showed up here, Marquise Knox. And what's going to happen? You know, Big George Rock, who's going to wander out here in a while, said, Chad, you need to hear this guy. And Chad heard him, and he's been back several times. And tonight, joining Marquise Knox and his band is going to be Joe Beard, who's, you know, wonderful right there. And of course, Lazy Lester. And Big George Brock, okay? And I always love to tell this story. Big George is 80 years old. I mean, you go to St. Louis, he is the blues. This is the young blues player from St. Louis. And I want to tell, this is especially for the women in the audience. Big George Brock has 42 children. And I love it when the hush kind of falls across the room. There are different mothers, not the same woman. So, okay, now, enough of me. Ladies and gentlemen, Blue Heaven Studios brings you Marquise Knox.
For Mr. Joe Beard, y'all. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. What about a hand for Marquise and the band, ladies and gentlemen? And I think we're gonna play the blues for you, ladies and gentlemen. Good at all. Whoa, pretty girl. Honey, you weren't doing too good at all. Yes, at the time you told me, little girl, honey, you didn't have no man at all. Now you're down on your knees, little girl. Baby, look at me up in my face. Now you're down on your knees, little girl. Baby, look at me up in my face. You're not trying to tell me, little girl, honey, you got another man to take my place. Oh, if it hadn't been for you, woman, honey, I wouldn't have been down here. Oh, if it hadn't been for you, woman, honey, I wouldn't have been down here. Yeah, be way in Chicago, honey, someplace far away from you. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. You know, I guess you know that they say all blues men drinks, right? I don't agree with it exactly, but I have been drinking. You know, when I get drunk, who's gonna carry me home? But when I get drunk, who gonna carry me home? Lord, when I get drunk, who gonna carry me home? Lord, I'm sober now, but I won't be sober long. The way you do. Every time I think about the way you do, Lord, then I'll get drunk and I don't care what I do. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Mr. Joe Beard. I think we're getting ready to bring another young gentleman out, Mr. Lazy Lester. Mr. Lazy Lester.
Nothing in the world as beautiful as a dead microphone. No, nobody hear you when they curse it out. You old dirty thing. Okay, now y'all got that song right now. Blue Stop Knocking. And I'll figure out my at my door. Can't you see my heart is so blues? Stop knocking at my door. What chance has this heart of mine? I deep blue. set me free and let my love come back to me. Everything I do seems wrong. In a crowd I stand alone. Blues, I'm knocking at my door. So there'll no longer be these blues knocking at my door. Why should I feel like I do when I tried so to be true? Blues stop knocking at my door. Thank you very much. See, it was a little jazzy around the ages, but you know what it means. When you get old like me, it's a lot of things you're going to miss. Trust me. Everybody out there 81 years old, hold their hand. See? Only one I see. See? You know, a little boy, this is not funny. He said, man, you told my daddy, you 75 years old. I said, yeah. He said, ooh, I don't want to get old. I said, you want to die young? He said, no. I said, well, you're going to get old then. I see my baby's face. Tonight. Oh, she cried and begged me, to fool. Darling, you know that isn't right. I started drinking early Friday. Until Saturday morning and broad daylight. Started drinking early Friday evening. Until Saturday morning and broad daylight. Oh, yes, it was. Anybody with any kind of sense knows I wasn't doing my woman right. Patrol wagon put me in Bold Alley jail. Oh, the patrol wagon got me, put me in Bold Alley jail. I didn't have to come and go my bail.
Thank you very much. Thank you. See, it,
somebody told me and said, oh, it was good, but it wasn't long enough. I was in Detroit. I walked up the stage and I said, what? It was good, but it wasn't long enough. Well, I didn't play but two. And somebody else said, yeah, I heard it was long, but it wasn't good enough. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Lazy Laster.